As we have successfully set up HDFS on our cluster using Cloudera Manager, now let us copy data into HDFS using command line and understand details about how data is stored in HDFS at a very high level. HadoopFS is the main command using which we can copy and manage files in HDFS. You can log into the gateway node and say HadoopFS and see list of commands that are available. And most of the subcommands that comes as part of HadoopFS with hyphen are similar to Linux. For example, you have cat, you have ls, so on and so forth. There is a separate section altogether where we'll be creating several topics with respect to some of the important commands that comes with HadoopFS. For now, we'll be using HadoopFS-put to copy files into HDFS before getting into the details with respect to how data is stored at a higher level. That being said, to copy data, first we need to have the datasets. I have a GitHub repository in which I have uploaded some datasets. You can actually go to github.com/dgadiraju and hit enter. There is a repository by name data, and you can actually clone the repository onto the gateway node, and you can take it from there. To clone, you just have to copy this URL, and first you need to make sure that you have Git or not. As of now, Git is not there. First, we need to install Git by saying sudo m-y install Git, which will take care of installation of Git for you. Once Git is installed on your gateway node, you can say git clone and paste that URL and hit enter. It will actually create a directory called data here, and that data will have a bunch of subdirectories. You can actually say ls-ltr data, and you can see the directories here. Cards is the dataset from here which we will be using to copy into HDFS. So you can actually say cd data and then cards, and then you can run ls-ltr command. There are a bunch of directories and files here. We'll start with decofcards.txt, and also we'll unzip this largedec.txt.gz, and then we'll actually copy the file. So that being said, let me go to the home directory and run gunzip data cards largedec.txt.gz, and then we can run ls-ltr data cards. Hit enter. You can also actually get the size in readable format by using LHTR. H stands for readable here. You can see we have decofcards.txt, which is only 693 bytes in size, and largedec.txt 693 megabytes in size. Okay, we'll be copying both the files into HDFS. That being said, to copy files into HDFS as user ITVersity, this ITVersity user need to have something called user space in HDFS. HDFS do not have users directly, but whatever OS user we are trying to use to copy the files should have a user space in HDFS. So first we need to create a user space for this user ITVersity. And the way you can do it is by using sudo hyphen u HDFS. HDFS is the super user who owns the HDFS file system in the cluster. So as HDFS user, we are trying to create directory structure mkdir-p. So as we have only tmp under slash, first let us validate that. You can say hadoopfs-ls/, and there is only one directory called tmp. Tmp is for other purposes where we store data for temporary purposes while processing. For permanent data, we need to have directory structures depending upon the planning within the organization for each project. But for regular users, we'll have user space under directory called slash user in HDFS. So here, you can say sudo hyphen u HDFS Hadoop FS. Mkdir is a command which can create either an individual directory or the entire hierarchy. In this case, I want to create the entire hierarchy by using hyphen p and then user ITVersity. Now both slash user and ITVersity under that slash user will be created. You can validate by saying Hadoop fs-ls slash, which will give you user as well as tmp, and then you can go to user to see the directory ITVersity as well. If you look at the owner of this user ITVersity or the user space ITVersity, it is HDFS and group is supergroup. And if you look into the permissions, the owner only have read, write and execute permissions on this user ITVersity directory. So only HDFS can actually copy data into this from this server, using commands like Hadoop fs-put. To overcome this, we need to actually use chown command to change the ownership of this directory called user itversity to itversity, and then using itversity itself we can copy the data. We'll be seeing these commands again when we actually get into the details about Hadoop commands as part of next section very soon. For now, even if you don't understand, don't worry too much about it. You just type sudo hyphen u. Even change owner should be running as HDFS user. That's why we are using sudo hyphen u HDFS, because HDFS is super user or the owner of the entire HDFS file system. And then you can say Hadoop fs hyphen chown itversity colon itversity. So both owner and group is itversity for this directory. And then you can say user itversity. Now the directory user itversity is created, and also the permissions are changed to owner as itversity in this case. So the user itversity, the OS user itversity, have read, write and execute permissions on this HDFS location called user itversity. So this is the home directory for user itversity. Either you can access this now by saying Hadoop fs-ls, hit enter. It will actually look for this directory structure. As we don't have any files in this location, it did not return anything. You can also say slash user itversity to get what you have as part of your home directory or user space. Okay, as of now there is nothing in that location, so both the commands are same. If you do not specify the path, it will actually look in the user space of this user called itversity on this on the HDFS cluster. That being said, now to copy the data, first we'll be creating a subdirectory under user itversity by name cards. So the way you can do it is by saying Hadoop fs-mkdir user itversity cards. As the directory is created, now we can say Hadoop fs-put. In our local file system, the cards is under data which is in my home directory. Either you can directly say data from here, because the relative path of cards is nothing but data, cards, and then the files which you want to copy. Or you can actually specify fully qualified path also, like home itversity and then data cards decofcards.txt. So either you can copy using fully qualified path of a file name like this, or you can also use relative path by saying data cards decofcards.txt. Once you specify the local file system as source to be copied into HDFS, now you can actually give the target, and this has to be HDFS path. So the HDFS user space for user itversity is nothing but user itversity. In that, we already created a directory called cards, and I want to copy this file decofcards.txt into it. Either I can say slash dot so that the file is copied with the same name, or we can actually give different name also for that file. Or you can actually delete this also. It will actually copy the file with the same name into that directory and hit enter. Now the file is copied. You can actually check by running Hadoop fs-ls on user itversity cards. You will see decofcards.txt. The 683 byte file is copied. Now let us copy the larger file also, which is nothing but data cards largedec.txt. This is the local path for this file, which is a relative path from the current directory. And then you can specify the user space, user itversity cards, or you can directly say cards also. It will automatically check for that cards directory under user itversity. If it exists, it will try to copy the file into that directory. If it doesn't exist, the largedec.txt will be named as cards in HDFS under user itversity itself. As we have a directory called cards under user itversity, this largedec.txt will be copied into this directory. You can hit enter. It will take some time to copy the file, because it's a 683 MB file. It has to be divided into blocks, and those blocks has to be distributed across the nodes in the cluster. Now if you say Hadoop fs-ls, you can see the files both logjack.txt as well as deckofcards.txt. This actually takes care of copying files into HDFS. Now let us go through the rest of the material by going through the content. All the commands which I have ran are already available here.